And that's what I said. Well, it's an issue for me. Oh, well, I never thought of it like that.
Yes. Hang on. Well, there's some good news and there's some bad news. The good news is the drain is clear.
And the bad news?
This.
I think this is ridiculous. I mean, how special can a valve be to be that expensive?
It's an unusual card, ma'am. I can tell you that. I'm just glad I had one in the band. Hey, Roger.
You forgot your shirts.
Hey, Tony, how you doing?
I'm swell. How about yourself? You forgot your hat! How big are your feet?
So who's this with the two-tone hair?
That's my hair behind her hair.
Oh.
That's my shoulder behind her shoulder. And this is Roger. Hi, Roger.
I think this is very healthy.
It is. You know what? You're a plumber.
Yeah.
What's your water pressure? Do you ever feel like...
It's a water-saving device. I took mine out.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you take mine out?
Sure. Who's this?
My boss. Total jerk. It's just like everybody at work. They see me every day and I'm doing these...
Videos?
Yeah. But I'm actually writing a script for a movie.
Really?
Yeah. And I think it's good. But the people at work, you know, all they know is what I do for them. And you know what? That's all they care about.
Yeah. What's this?
Oh, it was... A snowman. Roger broke it when I was moving. I made it.
Didn't tell us.
In the third grade.
Why do you keep it like this?
Look at it. Poor little guy.
He lives.
With the plumber who lives in my building. No. In my bedroom? In my bed, right now.
I don't know where my brain is.
Can't. He's a plumber. Yeah. No, he's really nice. Yes, it was good. It was good. It's not the point. Oh, I gotta go.
No. I gotta go get an appointment.
Oh. Listen, I don't know what to say about.
About when?
That's great. Cool. You were really sweet. Thanks.
Right.
Listen, I'm doing a reading of my screenplay next week. Am I right? I told you I was a writer.
Yeah.
Maybe you could come. I'd really like for you to come.
You would?
Yeah. Yeah. Here's a flyer. My writing group's so critical, and I would really love to get the opinion of an average person. I mean, I don't...
Yeah, right. No, I'll be sure to come and bring some of my average friends, and we'll give you some of our average opinions. You know, no real people get furniture like this. I mean, who buys this stuff? I mean, look at this.
Yeah, we can go here. Like that dresser.
Armoire. Oh. Now, see, Duke McKent has the Peruvian steam jet on his with the same healing powers as the geysers of Mount Barumba. I don't have that, do I?
Nope.
Can I have that?
Let's just say that you have to be a Duke to afford it. So let's see if you go.
This production company's paying me on Monday, so I can give you a post-dated check. Or if you come by the job, I can give you cash.
I'll take the cash. Where's your job? Oh. Arjun, Marlon?
Melanie Phillips.
Thank you. Can I speak to you?
Ooh, I don't know. We're running, like, really, really late.
Dave, hi. We're a little behind. Would you mind waiting?
Mind? Yes, I would mind. Yes.
You would? Hmm? Well, why don't you come in and watch?
Oh, big thrill.
No, really. Come on. It won't take long.
Nobody tells me anything. I don't know. What's going on.
Here. This is Melody.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
Yeah. Do I look good?
You do. Where do I know you from?
I don't know. I'm trying to place it. You know Sharon O'Hara?
You're Lloyd Hernandez?
Yep, that's me.
Oh my gosh. I've heard such great things about you.
You saw the show, right?
Yes, I did. You directed that? I didn't know you directed that.
Small world.
Small world.
Oh, hey, Dave. Thanks for waiting, man.
Okay, thanks. I'm sorry. This took only 6 for like 10 hours. Track fire.
Oh, you took 6. Say no more.
Is this Lloyd Hernandez?
No, it's not. But, he's gone. Okay. You know, listen, why don't you run upstairs and see James? My sister's probably here.
You said cash.
Oh, and it's supposed to date it to January.
I know I owe you. I know. Stupid clients, stupid jobs. I need to cast a movie.
So why don't you?
Well, I've never cast one, so nobody will hire me. You know, it's Catch 22.
Porterhouse?
What's better?
Is something wrong?
This. It's too hot.
It is Vindaloo.
Fine. I have the Tuscan vegetables. What are you looking at? Jesus, God.
Nothing.
Yeah, well, I think that table of nothing is flirting with you, Mr. Gunovich.
Yeah, well, it's because I'm with you.
What?
She thinks I'm somebody she should know. A writer, a director, or something like that. That's why.
Now, can we have your self-loathing seated separately, please?
Look, people have these perception categories.
Yeah, right. You mind them? So,
I'm the servant class. I'm invisible.
Hey, I mean, really, do you think you need to talk to me about perception categories?
Oh, okay.
No, really.
Okay.
All right.
Fine. That's fine, but it's true for me, too. I'm a plumber. No one sees me. It's true. I saw it on 2020.
Oh, Dave, what are you talking about?
Okay, don't turn around. Our waitress. Mm. What color's your hair? Her eyes? What's she wearing? Yeah, okay. Now, that director thing? His perception category? That is a whole different story. Bet you any woman he wants, he gets.
Maybe any actress.
Marjorie, I have a proposal. Two, actually. The first is, you leave me half my porterhouse.
Oh, sorry. And the second?
The tearing up of this check made out to $1,150. You will set up a casting session for a movie. of which I am the director. Oh, no, wait. No, you're serious. You treat me like I'm the director. I get to meet a bunch of beautiful women.
What would make you think that I would bring in a bunch of hungry, young, aspiring actresses?
$1,150, RJ. No. I'll throw in the Peruvian steam jet, the Duke of Kent's.
Oh, Nancy would flip. Oh, no, wait.
And everyone, RJ, will think that you are casting a movie. Much better perception category.
I'll do it. But, you gotta have it put in before Nancy gets back next month, because I'm doing this for her. I'm not doing this for me.
For Nancy, right.
Tuscan vegetables.
I'll need sides.
Signs?
No, sides. Scenes from a movie script. The women have to perform something.
Oh, yeah. Guess that's true.
Hey. Come in. Got all your stuff?
Yep.
I'm just gonna shut off the TV.
Stop ripping New Yorkers off. Bathroom's kind of a mess. Sorry.
That's all right.
It's really complicated what you have to do.
No. So is this the script?
Yeah. It's too bad you can't come to the reading. Hope your mother feels better.
They're doing tests. We'll see. But I'd be happy to take it home and read it if you want.
Oh, no, it's really not ready yet. I have all these changes.
Oh, come on, I bet it's great.
No, really, after the reading. Okay. I'm starving. I'm just going to go get some takeout.
What do you want to
have? Francisco, do you want anything?
No. You go ahead. Take your time. Eat there.
So nice of you to do this.
Hey, I said I'd do it.
Shut.
You got any beer?
Yeah.
It'd be great.
Yeah.
Where did you get these? From a girl who lives in my building. She does instructional videos for Bartlett Equities.
Oh, she must be very good.
You didn't say they had to be good.
Close the door. Why don't we, make up a name for you?
Okay.
Who's your favorite director?
Oh, well, Coppola. That'd be number one, I mean. The Godfather. Mm-hmm. I like E.T. And, Jaws. So Spielberg would have to be number
Fine.
Two.
Then you can be David Coppelberg.
Coppelberg, that's nice. Yeah.
And I think we found a title.
He's mine?
Hey.
Yesterday's Hollywood Reporter has been on Carl Everson there, and they really hack him to pieces. Thought you might enjoy that. This is who R.J. Martin wants for Pipe Dream, and this is the birthday card I should really send your mother today.
You can sign it.
Okay. Yes. Yes. That is not what I said. And he will tell you that is not what I said. And you can ask him, or I will ask him, and he will tell you that this was never said, because this is not in writing anywhere, George. I am telling you what I know as I know it, which is all I do ever. Well, you can speak with him, and then... Fine. Yes. Fine. I'm sure we will, George. Bye. What am I looking at?
The pretty way I dot my eyes.
Charlotte.
Piping requests. I'll just get this side down.
Where do they all come from?
Lots of agents selling them, lots of actors. Oh, by the way, I read those scenes. They're funny. You know, she's got an ear for dialogue and what?
Nothing. It's just that I know that she looks down on me for being a plumber, so I thought I'd return the insult and pity her for pursuing a dream that she had no chance of getting. But you're right. It is funny.
Okay, take four of the managers in show. Okay, Rich, you're doing great. Go ahead.
Numerous requests from a myriad of branch offices have prompted us at FSD, the Financial Statements Department, to re-examine our modes of efficiency in serving you, the brokers at Bartlett Equities.
That's right, Rich. On this tape, we'll be showing you the many ways that re-examination has impacted our speed of service delivery.
That's the best take, I think.
Good. Okay.
You know, I like that line, speed of service delivery. That's good. Did you write that, Tony?
That was Anya's, actually.
Listen, Tony, could you get Ned a copy of the revised script? The rest of legal still needs to go over it.
No problem.
Thanks. So, Tony, who do you like, the Yanks or the Mets?
I don't really follow baseball, really.
I know, huh? Well, are there any other, teams or sports you'd like to see a game of maybe sometime?
Actually, I'm a huge fan of bocce. Huh? Okay. Ooh, an audition. Movie. Maybe it's a big break, Marlis. Yeah, sure.
So, what's this all about?
This is it. Medicode.
That's all it is? Looks like a credit card.
The magnetic strips. Digitally encoded. It's all there in seconds. You go to the emergency room, there's no questions about medical history or allergies or whatever. It's saving lives already.
Great. 90 million? That's some buyout. Where do you end up in all this?
Richard. That's why I want to pick your brain. See, I'm buying a hotel in Florida and a ski resort in Ontario, but there's still a lot of money to unload, tax-wise.
So you want to give me some?
Oh, I thought, actually, why not get into something fun, too, you know? Like a movie or Broadway show or something.
Look at me, Rich. Do I look like I'm having fun?
You suffer, Arnie. That's your fun.
Arnie? That's when it's fun.
Looks like she's done well.
She'll crash and burn.
How's that?
Signing too many clients.
Oh. Thought she had her hands full with the one she took when she left you.
She took the dregs, Mitch. The dregs. Oh. Anna.
Arnie, hi.
How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Fine. Oh. Pipe Dream. That's that little indie, right?
Actually, I heard that Redford was a silent producer, so not so little. It's good to see you. Fan wants to know if she can see a copy of the Pipe Dream script. So does Jane Livingston. Sarah Lynch wants to know why I haven't submitted her for Pipe Dream, and could she see a script just in case?
What is it with this project? This is a nothing little movie, isn't it? Give me the casting director on the phone. What's his name? Arnie Hufflitz here. RJ, how are you?
Arnie Hufflitz. Yeah, I'm fine. How are you?
Good. Listen, RJ, Fiona Fallon loves these scenes from Pipe Dreams. Do you have a script?
Oh. The writers don't have polish, so we're not giving it out.
Who is it?
Who's what?
The writer.
The writer. Right, the writer is... Antonia Edelman.
What else has she done?
Well, she's been around, you know? I'm surprised you haven't heard of her.
Well, when it's done, send it to me.
Oh, yeah, no problem, no problem.
Thanks, BJ. Bye-bye. Charlotte?
Yeah?
Did you know that I was once a lawyer?
No, Arnie, I didn't.
Well, I was. And I gave it all up for an occupation that has an unlimited capacity for making me anxious and bitter.
If you weren't anxious and bitter, Arnie, what would be left?
Let's just make sure we get this straight. Now, again.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Good. And when they're done?
That was great. Thanks for coming in.
Yes, great. See, it's totally normal for the director to say next to nothing. They'll get the impression that you're thinking.
I'll be good, I promise. All right. There you go, Chief. Soon cometh the healing geysers of Mount Barumba. Good to meet you.
Hi, it's nice to meet you. I love your script. Are you the writer, too, or...?
No, I'm just the director.
Just the director. That's a good one. Knock! Well, where did you expect me to be? Tijuana? Auckland?
I don't know.
Well, I've been right here the entire time.
Shh, they're coming. We need to get into the office of the concierge. I have my hands pressed and the keys in my hands.
You have the key.
I feel like a basketball player on the road. They're all so...
Gee, maybe we ought to do callbacks.
Good idea.
You wanted a date, not a harem. Pick one.
Come on.
No.
I notice you don't have instant hot water on your kitchen tap. How inconvenient.
Oh, gee, I'm a burning hell for this. Okay, fine, David. Pick, like, I don't know, your top five and I'll set it up. But I'm gonna need new sides.
New sides? Why?
No sides, no session.
So pathetic. And manipulative and immoral. I get up at 5 every morning to write. To write this. Do you have a single clue what I put into this? Just every cruddy thing that's ever happened to me. Maybe one or two of the good things. Just so some hard-up plumber can use it to get laid.
People really like those scenes.
They did. Who are these people?
Actors. Actresses. That girl that's in that show, it's always about her little schnauzer.
God's Life?
Yeah.
Lena Peck, Reginine?
Yep.
Oh my God. She's amazing. She's smart. She's funny. She's pretty. She's not so pretty that you would hate her. She's perfect. Are you calling her back?
Hi, Marina, this is Boyd. You have a callback tomorrow for pipe dreaming. Is 2:45 okay? Great. Listen, there are new sides. I'll fax them as soon as we hang up, okay? Great. Really? Great. Bye. Do you know what Marina Pector said about the director?
What?
He said almost nothing to me, but I knew right away exactly what he wanted. It was really inspiring.
What are you doing at my desk?
You're at lunch.
No, you are. You are very important to him. To all of us. but maybe the best thing to do would be just let the pipe dream thing go for now, and who knows, maybe they'll want to see a whole new crop tomorrow. It's okay, it's what I'm here for.
So Charlotte, what's all the to-do?
Oh, this little nothing movie. It's inspired the most pathetic act of frenzy I've ever seen.
What movie is this?
It's called Pipe Dream.
Why in God's name would you do that?
I don't know, Mary. He's rumpled. I like rumpled.
So I've heard.
Why am I defending myself to you?
Oh, don't be like that, Jeanette. I only ask because I care.
Well, now I know why they're paying hotel rooms at Shade of Green. Thank you. That's fantastic.
Thank you so much.
And you, oh. Bad writing, really. Seriously, the dialogue just leapt off the page.
Oh, thank you.
So alive.
Thank you.
Seriously. Good.
Okay.
Take care.
Thanks for coming in.
She nailed it.
Lydia Spina canceled, so next is Marlis Funt.
Marlis Funt? Marlis Funt?
You know her?
I work with her. She'll ask all kinds of questions.
Wait a second. Keep your pants on. Marlis, hi. Come in. All right, here. How are you?
Nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Excuse me, can you tell me where I find the audition for Pipe Dream?
So, waking up without her wasn't new.
It's never how you think it's gonna be, is it, Miles? It's always different. So different that you don't even recognize yourself. Think about it, Miles. And then tell me that you don't know where the bracelet is.
Great. Amazing. Acting. I'd like to watch you do it again.
No, I really do appreciate your interest.
It's not just interest, Ms.
Edelman.
Ms. Edelman? I mean, I can tell you from what I know about your project.
It's just that we're really fully financed already.
Well, what project can't use more money?
What are you saying?
Well, I told him that we had some money, but we could definitely use more.
You're a nutcase.
This guy is ready to give us $2 million actual dollars.
For a movie that doesn't exist.
It can't exist. And you can cast it.
Yeah, but who's gonna direct it? The Roto-Rooter man here?
Hey.
I'll be his script supervisor at his elbow at every turn, telling him what to say, what to do. It'll look like he's consulting with me, but I'll actually be directing it through him. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Excuse me, there's someone named David Kulevich standing here, who is actually the best person to be talking to about what David Kulevich is or is not going to direct.
David, you can keep playing director. The man at the center, all these people, all these women hanging on your every word. Well, my every word, but they'll be coming out of your mouth. We have Maria Peck, such a casting coup.
Oh, I do love her. Hold on. If I do this, if I want Marlis Funt. Marlis Funt?
I want Marlis Funt.
David, I think you should leave the casting to someone who actually knows what he's doing.
Thank you. This can't be legal.
I know this lawyer where I work. I'll get him to do the legal stuff. He'll do whatever I say.
Tony?
No. I feel like all he needs is just, like, a little buttering up. Mm. Where are you going?
Walking.
Wait, you can't!
Watch my legs moving under me.
Wait, why am I arguing? Fine, okay, go. We'll get a real director.
Hey, David.
No.
Yeah.
Yes? You can have Marlis Funt. Can I come in?
Marlis Funt will play Janine.
What's going on?
As strange as this may seem, there's a buzz about this movie. And most of the buzz is about the director, which is you. So this computer guy wants the hot new director. You.
I can't believe I need you to make my movie.
But you do.
Directing pays a lot better than plumbing, David.
Money's a really bad reason to do something this crazy.
What about sex?
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Marlis Funt.
Just one thing, David. You cannot make a move on Marlis until we finish shooting.
What?
It's
It's kind of like the golden rule, David.
She's inexperienced. It'll mess up her head.
You're talking like what? 2 months here?
Just think of it as extended foreplay.
Yes, we are. No, Marlis is thrilled. We're all thrilled. Right, okay. Thanks, RJ.
Marlis Funt, you were going to drop her.
I was?
Yeah, you were.
Okay, I was. So what?
I just can't believe you didn't tell me it was your movie. Why didn't you tell me? Because we wanted you to get the part on your own merits. And you did.
Hey, Marlis.
Hey!
Oh, hey, congratulations on that whole movie thing. Sorry. Well.
Thanks. Who would have thought it? Like, Kismet or something?
Yeah, or something. Yeah, 5 minutes on those papers, okay?
Thanks, Ed. Tony, Ned said that you guys went to a, hibachi tournament.
Yes,
we did. Are you guys... It was just a date. One date. Okay.
Marlis Funt. Marlis Funt? When they could have had Marina Peck? The director must be an idiot. Who is the director?
His name's David Koppelberg.
The magician?
No. He's new. He's been directing theater in Eastern Europe or something. Anyway, he's hot. So? No agent.
Ah!
Action! Action on rehearsal. Cut. That's a cut. Cut! And cut!
So I've done my best to try to squeeze everything in, but 6 weeks is tight. But I think we're okay as long as there's no 11th hour creative brainstorming.
I don't think you're gonna have to worry about any of that with David.
That sounds good. Oh, and I ordered the extra headsets that you and David asked for.
Over the last minute, no, it's to me.
I hate yelling across the set.
That's good, good. All right, David, so, do you think the schedule's gonna work for your approach?
Well, who? I know that, you are as, assistant director, from what Tony said, real professional. I regard myself also as a professional. And I and I know we're on the same team. So I think if we just all get out there and each of us do our best, we can end up with a winner here.
All right.
Right?
Right, right.
Doesn't seem real.
It's not. It's plywood.
Not this. The movie.
Oh. That is very unrealistic. They would never put a waistline in there. It's against code.
I'm sure all the plumbers in the audience will be up in arms.
Well, here we all are. I know that none of you have worked with me before. I spent the last 2 years working in Holland. Tony and I met there last summer while I was directing an experimental workshop. As a result, you may find my style different. But I'm sure that we will find a common language. If not in technique, then in pursuit of truth in the work.
That's great.
So talented and so attractive, there's no room for you to be so nervous. Easy on the head, yeah? I'm sorry.
Yeah.
First shot's in here, huh?
The insanity of this occurred to me just now as I threw up my breakfast. If this is up to me, it isn't gonna work.
Well, it's worked so far. Tony, have you ever actually
directed anything before?
No.
Christ, you've got balls.
I don't. If I had balls, I'd be out there, but I'm scared, so I'm in here.
God damn it, and Marlis was just starting to warm up to me.
I'm not helping. You are not helping.
Everybody thinks your script is great.
I'm a writer, not a director.
Well, you couldn't have trained me unless you knew what you were doing. And any mistakes you make will look like mine. But you won't make any. I'm not worried. I totally trust you. Hello? Hello? Where's that working?
Turn it on.
Okay, so we're gonna do the master first, and then we're gonna do the lighting change for the close-ups.
All right, good. Good. All right, let's go. Okay, thank you.
I'll pat them both on the arm and say, I'm really excited to be working with you two.
Well, I'm really excited to be working with you two.
Thanks.
Tell
Clark to play the fear in the come-on.
Clark, I want you to play the fear in the come-on.
Even though he's coming onto her, it's about his fear that she'll reject him.
Because even though you're hitting on her, you're afraid she might blow you off.
Marlis? You're afraid too.
You're afraid too.
You're afraid you're falling for a guy who doesn't see you for who you really are.
You're afraid you're falling for a guy who's having trouble seeing you.
Wait, so he's going blind? Chris, no.
No.
You're afraid he sees you for something you're not.
You're afraid he
thinks you're someone you're not.
So perfect. I never saw it that way. So should we try one?
So, should we try one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, everybody. First position.
Good.
Like framing? Framing? Framing. Yeah. Perfect. Frame.
Okay, everyone, we're rolling.
17 apple, take one marker.
Action!
George is waiting upstairs. That is, if he's awake. He didn't get back until 3 o'clock in the morning. Which really didn't please Lillian.
I mean, that's what you think. That's not what I think.
It's a long way down, Niles. A long way down. I'd look if I were you.
Okay, everyone. Let's take the theme while we set up light for Clark's close up.
I told him they were great.
You're welcome.
I need to hear it. Keep saying it.
I'm
hungry. Can I get
that? Yeah.
Okay, thanks.
You guys are great.
Oh, yeah. You gave us exactly what we needed. We must have learned an awful lot in Holland.
No, no, it had nothing to do with me. You guys were fantastic. The way you were working, looked at each other,
yeah?
And you got up and you walked over here.
Autumn, right?
Yeah.
You don't have hot chocolate.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah?
Good. How you doing? You look better.
I tend to look better when I'm not doubled over a toilet. Thank you.
Who's David?
Look at him.
Hey.
Hey!
Hey, how's it going?
Great!
Good. God, I tell you, this is so much more fun than working with a bunch of computer nerds who can't remember to shower and think that knee highs are a food group.
I bet.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, come on.
Come on.
Hey,
come on. Come on. No, here we go, here we come go. On. Come on. To Tony, the finest ventriloquist since Edgar Bergen.
I'll have one more, please.
I mean, you know that Charlie McCarthy worked his ass off out there. You know how hard it is to look thoughtful and inspired for the whole day? That requires skill.
You did good, David. You did really good.
And Marlis was actually, okay.
Just needs a little extra care.
I'm all over that.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Let me get that.
So, how was it for you?
What?
Seeing your movie. Happening.
Well, I don't know if I can describe it.
Try it.
Well, it's like every job I ever had, it's like I was outside myself watching things happen, and today I was completely there.
Sounds good. Weird, but good.
It's just, you know what it is?
Hey, how are you?
You know what? I'm gonna just go over there and tell our leading lady how great she is. Look, slow down that tiger.
I know, the golden rule.
Hey, how's it going over here?
Hey, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good.
Whoa, look at that look.
Well, look.
I'm too late. I saw it already. You know, I've known David since I was like 10 years old. And I think I can say with some degree of reliability that he is not a dick.
Not a dick. Well, that is high praise.
Take a moment and think of all the men you've ever known.
Point taken.
So, scene 27 tomorrow. You see that wide angle or long lens?
Wide.
I'm getting a coffee. Can I get you some, David?
Oh, no, thanks. That stuff is so weak.
God, it is weak.
Yeah.
Yeah, this coffee's awful. I just like having something warm in my hand.
This is tea. No, actually, I meant that I was going to make some myself. I make it really strong.
David, the variety reporter is here.
Oh, right. Excuse me. Well, Lauren, if you look at the French, Truffaut, Mall, even Romer, there's a naturalism to the romance, and I want that in Patrick. So that even though the plot mechanics are pure farce,
the characters...
Characters are...
Not.
Not.
Oh, right. The characters are not pure farce.
Exactly.
Excuse me. David, but after we set up that light, we'll be back in about 5.
Right. Very good.
It's fine.
We're done. Thanks, David.
Thank you.
Do you mind if I hang around?
Absolutely not. Make yourself at home.
Your car is about to get towed.
Shit. Did they hook it up yet?
Yeah, I think so.
All set? Hey, David, there you are. Listen, we are ready.
Oh, sorry?
Yeah, and we're running behind, so if there's any last-minute notes for Marlis, you better get to it.
Now, huh?
Yeah, now. Okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Tony, where are you? Tony, come in.
Tony.
Would you look at this? Just for 1 second. It's permanent, you idiot!
Very constructive insulting you, lady. I'm gonna unhook you, but now.
Oh, wait, no. I'm sorry. No, hang on.
Hey. You wanna just wing it?
Wing it?
I just feel like I've been too strict on having you do everything my way.
No, you've been great. Your notes are great. A general note would be helpful.
A general note?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well... You're really trying to get from Miles what Carter's really been up to.
Okay.
You really want to connect with him. So that there's a flow between you. It's all about connecting. Otherwise, the feelings will leak.
Leak?
Yeah. If you're not connected. The feelings will leak right out of the scene. So I want you to stay focused on Miles. Connect with him. Flow with him. And don't leak.
Oh yeah, I got it. That's perfect. I totally know where to go with this now.
Okay.
What happened to you?
Where are we?
We're about to shoot.
You know, it's Marlis.
We were running behind. I gave her a general note.
The general note.
David, set.
What?
Yep. Let's roll.
Don't worry about it. It'll be fine.
Roll sound.
7, take 1. Marker.
Action.
Where do you think I've been? Tijuana, Auckland?
Okay, Marla, section.
Where do you think I've been? Tijuana? Auckland?
She's growing on me. No, she's not.
I've been right here the whole time.
And cut!
Oh, no. You're flowing. Flowing beautifully.
Yeah.
Yeah. Lovely Joe pushing me towards this field stuff, baby. The colors are so saturated. It's fabulous.
Yeah.
Action!
What do you think I
want to offer? You know, I just wanted to get started about the scene with where you and Miles are cornered in the laundry room by the bellhop.
Right. Yeah.
I was wondering if maybe we should get together and talk it over. Maybe Sunday?
Sunday, okay.
Okay.
Where have you been?
Sexy little director got himself a little ink.
Who is this guy? David. It's so good to finally meet you. Come, sit down. Do you want a drink? You've been on the set all day. You must be starving. Oh, let's have some wine. Are you cold?
Oh, no.
Well, the wine list, please, and some menus, and why don't you bring us some like delicious focaccia to start? I'm so pleased you're here. We'll have lunch, we'll talk, you know, not about the business, just about whatever. I want you to know, David, we are a full-service agency.
Mm-hmm.
Gotcha.
I don't understand how he could say those things to me. I understand how he was late to the dinner, but it doesn't add up. I don't know.
Cut, Fred. Cut, check the gate.
You like take three.
I think Zanini was off on three, low energy.
Huh. Off the gate.
Yeah.
Okay, people, let's move it on. 107, Morgan Stern.
David.
In the off.
I want to introduce you to Arnie Huffler. It's my agent.
Hey, Arnie, how you doing?
Good. Pleasure to meet you, friend.
Nice to meet you.
Marla's things here.
Yeah, it's fine.
She's got some really strong work.
Really, really strong work.
So, was it Hungary where you studied?
Holland. Glorious, glorious Holland, yeah?
So who represents you?
Oh, God, I don't even know which district I live in.
David, what else would you right now?
No, we're doing a problem soon.
There was a problem. The maintenance guy says it won't be ready for at least an hour. It's a plumbing thing.
Oh, really?
Oh, well, here's the problem. You gotta have equal pressure on both sides of the main valve. That's typical screw-up with these fits and bifurcated joints. Otherwise, you're not getting enough flow to the backflow prevention valve. So, if I just throw this puppy open, open all the way, and these babies will open up about 50, that should send it over to the butterfly.
Hey, don't fool with the pressure. She's gonna back up and cause a friggin' mess.
What the hell's he doing down there?
I don't know, there was a problem, so he just went in there.
Well, you know, David's always been pretty handy.
Hey, Harold, can I get it to work? Throw the switch.
All right, he's coming up. Let's clear.
Okay, Harold, let it rip.
He's like the Renaissance man.
You have no idea.
Yeah, I remember my father once telling me that, you know, it won't make you famous, it won't get you rich, but it's important work. He'd be horrified to learn that I didn't become a beekeeper, too, but turns out that I'm allergic to bees. Yeah, one sting and anaphylactic shock. So, there's that. But the point is, you know, what good have I really done as a lawyer?
Well, you helped me.
Oh, those movie contracts? That's easy, yeah. I like you.
To the Shad Festival, I did, because I had family in Fayette County. And then at least one of my parents would come with me to the others, because if you don't have a chaperone, don't get to be in that.
God, it must be fun being so admired.
My family was proud. But, I don't know, standing around being beautiful didn't seem like much of a career to me.
I wouldn't know.
Thank you.
Nice green. Enjoy.
David, I can't tell you how lucky I feel that you chose me for this part. Strong female roles are, like, non-existent, and Tony really did a great job. Hmm. It's funny, because when we were at Bartlett together, I had no idea that she was so talented.
Oh, hey, Manny, how you doing?
When are you gonna come over for my sake?
Saturday.
That's what you said last Saturday.
No, I mean it.
This Saturday?
This Saturday.
Not next Saturday.
This Saturday.
Saturday.
This Saturday.
All right, you better, because that thing's driving me nuts, all right?
All right, man.
Take care.
See you later, man.
What was that?
Before I got to direct, I had a day job, just like you, and I was a plumber.
What?
It's true. I'm joking. I'm joking. He's just selling me a sink. It's a deco thing. He wants to get rid of it.
You dog, I bought that. A plumber.
Plumber. Being the director.
Yeah, me being the actress.
Right. Oh, absolutely. I totally understand. It doesn't have anything to do with,
No. Definitely. Wow. It was great. This is totally about us working well together.
Okay. Hey, Adam.
Hey.
I could really go off one of them chocolate...
Oh, the chocolate covers with the covered vanilla frosting.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, let's kick a hatch. Man. Almost done, too.
How long you been doing this?
All morning.
No, I mean, craft services. Seems like a good gig.
Are you kidding? No, this is the suckiest job in the film universe. No, I'm the lowest of the low. I'm a slug. You do it once, just get in the door, that's it.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, it doesn't holler. You know, it's a prestigious job.
Must be high, man. Hey, you get that? High in Holland.
Right,
yeah.
Right,
go. Did you have fun last
night? What?
Dinner. Marlis.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we didn't discuss the...
Bellhop in the closet scene in great detail.
And then you went on to discuss the electron theory of subatomic particles.
This is so flattering.
What?
This, how you behaving?
How am I behaving?
Jealous. All right, right. Now you wouldn't be jealous of me. I'm a plumber.
What?
You remember, the night we were together?
Morning after. The phone conversation in the kitchen.
I heard the whole thing.
I knew you. I was wrong. I was stupid.
You were wrong about me.
Yes.
Okay.
This isn't about you or me. This is about the movie. Marlis can't be with you. She can't handle it.
She can't handle it. Oh, okay. I got it.
whatever.
Since Mitch and his wife are buying this.
Mitch Farkas is taking out for dinner.
Yeah, he wants it back before he mounts the piper.
Great.
Yeah, he's a big guy.
Sorry, bracelet.
Let's do it again.
So, what do you
want to
do?
Let's do it again.
So?
Jesus, even I can tell she's missing something here.
You mean talent?
What do I do? Maybe I should try that what if thing. Like, what if it was your brother that Carter shot? Or what if your child's life were at stake?
What if I fired you?
Yeah, right.
Okay. Let's try this again. Phil, that's great. Just lose the cough. Clark, keep doing what you're doing. I like it. And, Marlis,
here's what I want you to try for. Try to forget that Carter is dressed in a clown suit and that Miles Fairman only has one testicle. Carter just shot someone. You might all be in a great deal of trouble, not to mention danger.
Tony, you got new goldfish, and they assure me that you're going to be much more.
How'd you feel? If Carter shot your brother.
Well, I don't have a brother.
Okay, how'd you feel if it was your mother?
Why would they shoot her?
How'd you feel if I fired you? I didn't mean that. I was just trying to give you an example.
What did you do?
It just slipped out. I think you better call lunch.
Everybody, that's lunch.
I'm having trouble understanding where she's at this point in the script. What Janine is, what you are, is a girl who wants a normal life. She wants what she sees other people have, or at least thinks they have. Friends and love and work, security. And you think you're finally gonna get that with Miles Fairman, right? Okay. But you haven't been honest with him about who you are. And now this game that you're playing with Carter threatens to ruin everything. You see? And don't worry about it being funny. It will be. It's just that Janine takes it so seriously. That's what's funny. Okay, so there's more at stake. But if
I... Got it, everybody.
But what if, Marlis, you got it? You do. If you didn't, I'd tell you. Believe me.
Maintenance about the leaky sink. Lewis said you might be here. Can I come in? I'm sorry about the Marlis thing. She wouldn't have gotten like that. Look, I slept with her. Just once.
I knew that.
You knew that?
Girls talk.
Jesus.
She said that it was a mistake, and that was that.
Right. We could see if it would hinder our working together, so.
That was that.
Exactly.
I have some work to do.
Do you think I'm scum?
Do you care?
I would like it if you thought I wasn't scum. I mean, the opportunity presented itself, and I took it. Isn't that what most men do?
Most movie directors, yes. But you're a plumber. I expected more of you.
Maybe we shouldn't do this till the movie's over. I don't want to mess with your head.
Your clogged pipes? Is he cleaning out your wallet? We called 10 plumbers to this apartment building in Manhattan to fix a very simple problem, and caught several charging shameful sums, installing unnecessary equipment, and taking hours to do repairs that should have taken minutes.
You see this right here, this thing? If it was that, it would not be a big deal. It would not be expensive. But it's this, and this is not easy, and this is it.
This is David Kulovich. Has he been to your house?
He's a European. I have to look at my book. I think I still remember the money that, $250, $300.
You'd be surprised how many plumbers are flushing New Yorkers' hard-earned money down the drain.
Jesus, where are you, David?
Nice carpet. Very plush.
Captain, how's it going?
Pretty good, man.
Saw you two at the coffee cart this morning. Is there something you want to tell me?
Oh, no, your coffee's great. We were here working early.
Yeah.
Do you have any jellies?
Yeah. I got loads. I got jellies. I got Bavarian cream. I got crullers. I got those little...
I'll just take the jellies, actually.
All right.
Okay.
Right.
They do, don't they?
Yeah.
Okay. I left my watch on the nightstand. Okay, well, are you gonna...
Yep.
hi, Morris. Listen, I'm really sorry.
I mean, I thought, you know, what am I gonna do? I quit my job and... My agents are probably going to drop me, and nobody's ever going to hire me again.
No, 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 no. No, 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 no.
You're not really into this, are you?
No. No, not really. There's someone else. I think.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah.
That's okay.
Hey, kids.
Hey, David, a second of your time?
Yeah.
I think we're going to have to reschedule tomorrow. I just heard the weather report. It looks like rain.
Excuse me,
one second.
Please, just...
David,
you see yourself on TV last night?
What?
It was one of those shame on you sections on the news about rip-off plumbers, and one of them, I swear to God, it looks exactly like you. Like separated at birth.
David, he's nuts. You're much cuter than that guy. Don't listen to him.
Where's he going?
Shit,
This is not going to go over well with the union. I'll be lucky to get a suspension.
The union? What were you doing? It's just so sleazy. You were so completely sleazy.
Come on, Tony. I was sweetening. I was padding.
Padding? You were stealing. You're a thief. You'll screw anybody, whoever's around.
A few $100 from a couple of rich clients who treated me like garbage.
Oh, the rich ones.
Wow. You're good. You really had me fooled.
Fooled? Look, Tony, I'm sorry.
Sorry, David? Sorry about what? Sorry that you're a cheat? Sorry that you got caught? What else? Oh, Marlis, yeah. That looked like one hell of an apology.
Oh, shit. Oh, my God. No. Listen, she fell apart. She was crying, and then I was patting her on the back, and then, I don't know, she kissed me. I was just trying to make her feel better. It was nothing.
Wow. Wow. The transformation is complete. Congratulations, you're not a plumber anymore. You're a director.
Tony, would you just please ask Marlis? You know what? Forget it. Don't. Believe what you want. Because who am I? I'm a sleazy plumber who padded a few bills. Just don't forget who you are. A writer who took $2 million from a rich guy named Farkas. And let's not forget about the little lawyer friend, Ned, that you've been stringing along. Is that any way to treat anybody? You what?
Oh, hey, guys. They're here.
Eddie with a laminar sash.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hello.
Hey, Mitch. How are you? David.
Yeah? I saw plumbing in Holland. Isn't that where you were trained?
Mitch.
You are fired.
If you just...
You two, fired. Who are you again?
I'm just the casting director.
You're also fired.
Where are we going? Fine, I'll get my own cab.
I don't want to run into David at home. Can I just crash at your place?
Oh, yeah, no problem.
My plumber
became a director.
Yes. Book deal.
They didn't have Ovaltine, so I got you Bosco.
Oh my God, the steam shower is amazing.
Oh yeah, well it should be.
What do you mean?
David put it in.
Oh yeah, right. Can you throw me a towel?
Here you go.
So your career's over, but at least you got a shower out of it.
Oh, yeah.
It's a lot more than I got.
You okay?
I just can't believe they gave my movie to the director of the Spice Girls video.
I swear to God, that was a completely legitimate repair. I would never take advantage of your bad eyesight, Mrs. Malloy. Okay. I want you back in the movie. What are you talking about? You have to finish directing my movie. I've got to go, Mrs. Malloy. All righty, bye. Hey, I don't know about you, but I don't like looking like an idiot. And if it gets out that I was taken by a plumber, I mean, no offense, I will be the subject of every other joke told in Silicon Valley for months. But if the movie is good, all this will go away.
What happened to your new director?
No charm. Shot a shoe falling from 15 different angles. Doesn't have your... whatever.
Mitch, I'm just a plumber.
Okay, and Harrison Ford was a carpenter.
What about Tony?
I need a director. I need you. I can't help her.
Mitch, you know the story of Cyrano?
What are you talking about?
You know, the
The old guy with the big nose who tells the handsome, young, stupid guy.
I know the story. What's the point?
On Pipe Dream, I was the handsome, young, stupid guy.
Who's got the big nose?
I'm looking for David Koppelberg.
Well, he is in his trailer and refuses to come out.
Hey.
Hey.
I talked to Marlis. I'm sorry. I should have believed you.
You know what the great irony here is?
No.
Neither do I. I honestly don't know how I'm gonna make a living. Nobody will hire me since this.
Aww, you'll plumb again.
I'm a good plumber. Steady line of work my dad left me, but this thing, working like we were in the movie, you know, every day was different and kind of wakes you up, yeah? Felt good.
I don't know. So you need a job, huh?
Tony's setting up the shop with DP. It'll take a couple minutes. If you want to pick up the coffee,
great. Thanks.
Kind of looks like you're out of sugar up here. Cream filled?
Yeah, there's a cream, yeah.
Thanks.
Hey, Marlis.
Oh, hi. Just getting my coffee.
Can I interest you in,
Nope. One more donut, I'll explode. See ya. Oh, shoot. I was supposed to bring Tony a, Ovaltine.
Oh, that's right, I'll get it.
Yeah? Thanks. All right, well, touch up. See ya. Thanks. Did you see that? That last scene?
Yeah, I did. Yeah.
What do you think?
What I think?
Yeah.
The last line? I think it'd be funnier if she dropped the umbrella first.
We could do that. What about the opening? The wet newspaper?
Oh, that was good.
Yeah?
Okay. I thought that rang true, yeah.
I don't want that to seem forced.
No, it wasn't forced.
No?
No.
Okay,
no. I like the smacking across the
really?
Face.
I'm thinking of later when she comes out from under the ladder with the birthday cake. Yeah. I'm thinking of having, doing that.
What do you call it?
The
thing.
What's
that called?
A crane.
Crane?
Yeah.
No, I think that would be a good idea.
So what I'm thinking is Jeanette should put down the cake first.
Yeah, after the cake.
Yes.
Because if she's still holding the cake.
Thanks,
Otis.
Thank you.
Hey. What about this, in here, this...
The wall?
There's like nothing back there.
Yeah, you're right. I guess we could put something there.
What about Grandma?
Right.
And the lazy boy.
Yeah.
With the little blanket on her.
That's kind of sweet.
Ready?
Why not?